Here's a little monologue that was done by a guy called Stanley Holloway. Now, Stanley Holloway was, I think he was a southerner. He certainly spoke with a London sort of an accent. But he put a Lancashire accent on for this particular piece. I'm going to have to read it because there's a lot of words on here, but it's something I've always wanted to do. So bear with me. If it doesn't work out, you'll never see this. You ready? It's called Albert and the Lion. There's a famous seaside place called Blackpool that's noted for fresh air and fun. And Mr. and Mrs. Ramsbottom went there with young Albert, their son. Fine little lad were young Albert, all dressed in his best, quite a swell. He'd a stick with an horse's head handle, the finest that Woolworths could sell. Now they didn't think much to the ocean. The waves, they were piddling and small. There were no wrecks and nobody drowned. In fact, nothing to laugh at all. So seeking for further amusement, they paid and went into the zoo, where they had lions and tigers and camels, and cold ale and sandwiches too. There were one great big lion called Wallace, whose nose were all covered with scars. He lay in a somnolent posture, with his face on the side of the bars. Now Albert, he'd heard about lions, how they was ferocious and wild. To see a lion lying so peaceful, well, just didn't seem right to the child. So straight away the brave little fella, not showing a morsel of fear, took his stick with his horse's head handle and he stuck it in Wallace's ear. You could see that the lion didn't like it, for giving a kind of a roll, he pulled Albert inside the cage with him and he swallowed the little lad whole. Now mother had seen this occurrence. Not knowing what to do next, she hollered, "Yon lion's et Albert!" And father said, "I am vexed." They complained to an animal keeper, who said, "What a nasty mishap. Are you sure it's your boy he's eaten?" Pa said, "Am I sure? Here's his cap." The manager had to be sent for. He came and he said, "What's to do?" Ma said, "Yon lion's et Albert, and him in his Sunday clothes too." Father said, right, young fella. I think it's a shame and a sin to have our son et by a lion, and after we've paid to come in." Well, the manager wanted no trouble. He took out his purse straight away, saying, "How much to settle the matter?" And Pa said, "What do you usually pay?" But mother had turned a bit awkward when she saw where her Albert had gone. She said, "No, someone's got to be summoned." So that was decided upon. And off they went to police station in front of a magistrate chap. They told what had happened to Albert and proved it by showing his cap. Magistrate gave his opinion that no one was really to blame. And he said that he hoped the Ramsbottoms would have further sons to their name. At that, mother got proper blazing. "And thank you, sir, kindly," says she. "What, spend all our lives raising children? To feed ruddy lions? Not me."